So there's a pretty spirited debate going on right now in the comments section of my reaction video to our first look at Amber Heard as Mera in the upcoming Justice League movie. I don't like it. I don't like the costume, but a number of you are defending it, saying it's fine. It looks better than anything Marvel's ever done in the MCU. What else would you like to see? Do you want it to be more revealing, etc., etc.? So to spin out of those comments, I thought it would be fun to take a look at all the MCU and DCEU costumes so far for women and rank them. I'm going to give you my ranking, and I'd be very curious to hear your thoughts down below. I'm not going to include the Fox Marvel female costumes because pretty much, I mean, the Fantastic Four movies have failed, and when it comes to the X-Men movies, you know, either you have Naked Mystique, or, you know, you had Naked Mystique, and then all the other costumes are uniform. You know, they're not really, they're not individual costumes like we're seeing in the MCU and the DCEU. So let me tell you what my criteria is, and there are chapter times noted down below in the video description if you'd like to skip around, because as you can see, this is a long video because there's actually been a lot of female characters so far. So that's pretty nice. That's something we can all celebrate. So my criteria for judging these costumes is the following. Number one, it has to be representative of the original character. But number two, it needs to be plussed for the movies. And what I mean by that is that it needs to create some excitement, right? Like, ah, you know, this is the movie version of the costume, right? And then also, it needs to have a real world practicality, because in the comics, you know, there's not as much detail as a real world costume needs to have. And also, you have the mainstream audience coming on board. And so certain things, you know, in order for it not to seem silly or too comic booky, you know, changes need to be made. They need to step up their game, so to speak. Then three, it needs to look like an A movie versus a B movie, right? I mean, and that's one of my biggest problems with the costume for Mera in Justice League. Some people are saying, who agree with me, that it looks like a Power Rangers costume, right? And you don't want what's supposed to be one of the biggest movies of the year, Justice League, to ever be mentioned in the same sentence as the Power Rangers movie. Although that's getting a lot of buzz, but I think the reaction to the actual trailer was mixed. But anyway, you see what I'm saying there. And then finally, number four, that women would want to wear it. Now, I know for a lot of guys, there's the hotness factor, and so I can't weigh in on that, so I'd be interested to hear your thoughts on that down below when it comes to these costumes. But I can tell you from a female audience perspective, it certainly helps the character when we look up and see one on screen and go, I totally like to raid her closet, right? All right, so let's get started. I'm gonna go from worst to best. And again, if you can't wait to see what the number one is, etc., you can jump around via the chapter times in the video description. So the worst costume, I think, so far is Sif from the Thor movies. Sorry, Sif. I mean, it's a horribly underwritten role. It's really just there, I think, because they wanted to have a female as Guardian. But I think that my biggest problem with it is that it's just like a female variation. Not even just a female variation of the Thor costume, but it's like not as much effort is made, right? Like they were like, this is not going to be on screen for that long. You know, we don't have to try that hard. And I think that when you think of how the character has looked in the comics, sometimes sporting like this amazing fur collar and like some cool like sashes, some red sashes, I've seen Sif look really cool. So when you think of all those elements, I think it could be much more compelling. Also, the shield and the sword, they look also kind of like they're from Party City. I just think that the costume is not particularly well executed. So I think that's the worst costume so far. Next, I gotta go with Nebula from Guardians of the Galaxy. I tried to factor in the villains in here as well. Now, she looks, you know, to the fairness of the costume designer on this film, the comic book character didn't give them much to work with. And I think this is pretty accurate, but for instance, like look at the metal arm, right? Like when I was looking at the comic book illustration, I was like, they didn't even give Nebula a metal arm. And then I was like, oh wait, they did. So I feel like the costume's you know, failure to play that up is part of, like for instance, you're really very much aware of the Winter Soldier's metal arm, right? Why isn't that the same situation with Nebula? And also I remember that Karen Gillan shaved her head for this. And I think when you see the final product, you're like, I think a skin cap would have been okay. I don't really think that, you know, when she came on screen, you weren't like, who's that, right? So that's why she's the second worst costume I think we've had so far. Then next, I'm going to go with Katana, which is also faithful to the comics. And I think a lot of people really got behind Katana because they were so excited to see an Asian female character in the comic book movie realm. But I think that, you know, they didn't do anything to really plus the costume. I think it's a little bit too faithful to the comics, right? There's nothing exciting about it where you're like, wow, like, that's even cooler than I've seen in the comics. Like, I think you want to, as I said, that's one factor that you want to have there. And also, I feel that because it's not particularly cool and it's not particularly sexy, I don't see a real, I want to wear that factor here, right? I mean, it's just kind of there. Like, you look at her and you go, yeah, that's Katana, but I think, and that's really where like the coolness factor stops, unless you want to go into, you know, represent Katana, right? And that has nothing to do with the costume. Then next, I have to go with Mera. As I've said in my review of it, I personally have problems with the practicality of it. It doesn't look like anything you would wear underwater. I do agree with the Power Rangers comparison. I just don't think that I have problems with, you know, actually, I don't want to talk about how anyone looks in their costume. But, you know, I think that, you know, there's no fun factor here. And as I said in some of my responses to people who didn't like my critique of it, you know, I think that, you know, if you squint, it does look like the comics, right? Like, yeah, you know, it's got the crown, it's got the green, it's the green bodysuit. But what's one of the cool things about Mera's bodysuit in the comics is that it has a green sparkliness to it, right? Like, it looks like it has like the shimmer of the water at night, like with the light, the moonlight hitting it. That's very cool. And I don't see that here. I also think that I've never really liked Mera's costume in the comics, to be perfectly honest. Maybe that's one of the reasons I don't like this so much. And I think that the movie missed an opportunity to improve upon it vastly. So that's frustrating to me as well. Then next, right after that, I do have to go with Scarlet Witch. And that's because, again, this is not particularly inspired. Now, the character's super cool because of her power set, right? But I feel like with the costume, it looks like she just, you know, went to Hot Topic, right? And, you know, I think that the costume is so not cool that you actually don't see her don it very often in the movies for that reason. No one's like, oh, make sure she puts her costume back on. I think, you know, as long as she's using her power set, it doesn't really matter what she's wearing because nothing that she has is purely inspired. I mean, you know, this character's supposed to care about her heritage, right? She lost her parents to Tony Stark's weaponry. I don't see her heritage represented anywhere in the costume. They could have perhaps gone in that direction. I mean, it's a real world application of how the character looks in the comics, so that's nice. But again, it's a missed opportunity to, you know, improve upon the costume and plus it. For reference, look at basically every Suicide Squad costume. And that's actually the next, another witch, right? We go from the Scarlet Witch to the Enchantress. And I actually liked her costumes quite a bit in Suicide Squad. I felt they seemed very ancient, right? Like this ancient, I think, you know, South American Enchantress, this witch. I thought that, you know, here you can see look like she's dug her way out of the dirt because, you know, that's where she was uncovered. And I like the fire that floats around her. I thought that was a really good choice. I mean, there's a lot going on here to catch your eye, which I thought was fantastic. And then when she upgrades later in the movie, I thought this was really cool too. I love the use of symbolism on the costume. I liked the eyes that are part of this headpiece. I thought that was really cool. And I think she seems very powerful. I think that if there are any problems with Enchantress in the movie, it does not have to do with her costume. I thought it was really neat. I really liked it quite a bit. And again, it was a really big improvement, I think, on the hoodie / cape that she's worn in the comics, right? So I think they did a great job here. Then next, I'm going to go with Gamora, right? So the reason I like Gamora is that, well, this is a fairly traditional costume. I think there are nice little tweaks to it that make it seem, you know, that made them improve upon it as much as they could for something that still needed to seem, you know, very tactical, very utilitarian, right? So I think one of the best choices was giving her the pink highlights at the end of her hair. I think that's fantastic. I think it makes the character look really cool and it jazzes up the costume and really makes her, you know, pop when you're just, you know, she catches your eye. I thought that was a great choice. I also like the way they kind of incorporated a necklace into the actual suit because, you know, she can't actually wear a necklace Well, she has some rings, but she can't really run around with the necklace because it would flop up and hit her in the face during her action sequences. But by putting this kind of like silver, these silver jewels, embedding them into the collar of the costume, but still, you know, the vest still gives a peephole to show a little cleavage, so keep it sexy. You know, it gives her that necklace effect. I also love the mesh. Mesh, you know, Gamora is ahead of the curve. Mesh is very popular right now in workout clothes, etc. So she has those cutouts there, which I think looks really nice. You know, it's sexy without being too revealing. Like it teases, which I think is really nice. And I also, she has a great sword. I think her sword is, it's really big. It seems like it's very powerful, and she looks like she knows how to use it. And I love the gauntlets, the leather gauntlets as well. I think she seems like super cool. It's practical at the same time. I think it's a very good costume. Also, everybody loves skin color, right? Green skin. I think that's nice, and that helps that pop as well. Then next, we haven't seen her don it yet, I really like the way they've reimagined the Wasp's costume for Evangeline Lilly. And I think Evangeline Lilly's haircut is a big part of why this costume works so well. Fantastic, cute, adorable bob, incredibly likable to women. And I think the cute is a good way to describe her costume. You know, they went with sleeveless, but then adding the gloves, I think, makes it just really adorable. So I think that's a great choice. And, you know, she's going to be covered with the helmet. So, again, the sleeveless shows a little bit of sex appeal, but it still keeps it practical and without being too revealing. I love the red piping on the legs and also around the neck. And it creates also like an insect feel to it as well. And the wings just look absolutely fantastic. So I think this is a great costume. I can't wait to see it in action. Also, the bob, now that I think about it, will disappear under the helmet, so there's a practicality factor there as well. I think I can see a lot of women wanting to wear that costume. Now, we're getting close to the end here. Now, the next best costume, I think, by far and away, is Black Widow. And it's especially good when you think about where it's come from. When the character first showed up, let's talk about Party City. She looks like she has a Party City quality wig on, and the costume looks like she's just, you know, pretending to be a secret agent. There's absolutely no protection built into it. The weapons don't look real. I mean, it looks painted on. I think it's a really poor costume. I mean, just look at the Widow's Sting gauntlets around her wrist. They look like she made them out of like cardboard rolls, right? It's a really horrible costume. But then, look how much she's evolved over the course of the films. She still has great hair. As I said, who's doing blowouts at Avengers Tower every day, right? But it's very much a very strong professional look, right? So I think women are going to really respond to that. She has much more coverage. She's got the knee pads. She has different padding and protective things strapped on here to protect her in a fight. She's decked out with tons of weapons, right? I think that's really important as well. And she has, this is like real world practicality. You know, in the comics, Black Widow, she wore a black catsuit, right? And she had the Black Widow symbolism on her belt. And she had often the gold, like 1960s go-go dancer look to that added to that. This looks like a real spy with just enough fantasy to make it fit in the comic book realm, but something that Black Widow can wear easily on missions, but then also she can easily, transition into the conference room for debriefings, etc., go into S.H.I.E.L.D. headquarters and feel totally comfortable. It's a great costume. I love it. I think it just could not be. I just love that costume so much. But it's not the best costume because we're not quite done. Now, it was very hard to choose the best costume, but at the end of the day, I felt there was no comparison. And the runner-up is Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman. I've come to really like this costume as we get a closer look at it. I think that it's incredibly faithful to the comics, but it's done away with the problem of Wonder Woman not wearing pants, which has been a problem for a lot of women with the character. And I think that's one of the reasons that her costume hasn't, and she as a character hasn't totally caught on. But now by giving her like this Greco-Roman skirt, it really fits with still, again, being faithful to the character, but having a practicality-ness to it. It's got the color, but it's muted. It very much seems like battle armor, but they were still able to maintain the imagery in a tasteful way, such as the eagle plate on her chest and the tiara and the boots, right? But the boots seem very practical, the way they're put together. I love every time we see in a trailer and a close-up how they are very much like armor. And it really just looks like, you know, she's a warrior from a different period. And I think it's great. It's extremely practical. She looks amazing in it. Fantastic hair. And she looks like she means business, right? And it's partially the performance. It's partially how she wears it. But Gal Gadot makes you believe that she's protected, but she also has, a lot of movability and, you know, it makes her really a threat on the field. It's gone from being something that seemed incredibly impractical in the comics to something that makes total sense in the context of the films. And that is a huge win for the costume department when it comes to the DCEU. Could not like this costume more at the end of the day. That first photo that they revealed did not do it justice, but it's come a long way. Then the best costume by far and away is Harley Quinn. It was shocking to first see, but it has proven to be enormously popular. And I think that a lot of credit has to go with creating something that was just so instantly popular, not just with comic book fans, but here's where it really wins, with non-comic book fans. They made Harley Quinn perhaps the most popular comic book character there is with the mainstream audience. That's a huge victory. Now, one of the best things about it is that anyone can wear this, and that's the Marilyn Monroe factor. One of the reasons that Marilyn Monroe was so popular was that she was just so heavily made up, and it was largely a costume even with her. The blonde wig, the heavy eye makeup, the red lips, the beauty mark, anyone felt that they could do it. And, you know, you had other actresses try. And to some degree, succeed. It wasn't so much, you know, it was so washed out that the face became not as important, right? Anyone could insert themselves into the costume and into the look. And I think that this version of Harley Quinn plays off that beautifully. Anyone can have the white blonde hair with the pink and the blue tips and the smudged makeup. It's also a very flattering look to white out the complexion, have the dark eyes, the white blonde hair. It's a look that's flattering to almost anyone. So it's very, very clever. And also, they were able to make it something that became very powerful, like owning the look and women feel, you know, it's the ultimate slutting yourself up for Halloween, right? Like everyone has talked about for a long time, how Halloween has become this holiday where it's okay. It's the one day of the year where anyone can just go be overtly, you know, slutty, right? And they took that and they ran with it and they made it a professional level because it looks like a real costume. It doesn't look like cosplay or anything like that for the Harley Quinn character in the movie. So they took what made Halloween become more popular with women and also men, I think, by result. And legitimized it and gave something that was like an icon of that. And I think that's really impressive. And they played off of the popularity of like the line of dolls that are very popular, right? Like Monster High and, I forget the name off the top of my head, but the dolls that compete with Barbie, right? I mean, it's really played into a lot of what women consider really gorgeous and desirable these days. So really, really well done. And I think that's by far and away the most successful comic book costume we've had to date. So that's my ranking of the female comic book character costumes we've had so far. I'd be very curious to hear your thoughts on this. Be sure to rank them down below. And you can check out some more videos, including that reaction video to the Mera costume right now.